Hallelujah, we thank you, God. Open wide the gates, hallelujah. And let the King of Glory come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. He is the King of Glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah, King of Glory, hallelujah. We open wide the gates, King of Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. The Lord strong and mighty, hallelujah. The Lord mighty in battle, hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. To the King eternal, the Almighty God. Hallelujah, omnipotent God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, shukura, basi, andolo, kosi. Yelele, mokoro, soro, kosi, amelia. Glory, shukura, heavens declare the glory of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Get your expectations high today. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh Lord, my God, thou art very great. Hallelujah, you are clothed with honor and majesty. We bless your name today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And forget not all his benefits. Oh, who forgive all thine iniquities and heal all your diseases. Who redeem thy life from destruction and crown with thee with loving kindness and tender mercies. Oh, bless the Lord.
Oh,
Yeah. Arriba, mamá, mamá,
Arise above your doctor's report. Arise above it.
Hallelujah. I thank you that we get getting serious about the things of God, Lord God. That we're getting serious about the word, Lord God. That we're getting serious about the ministry of reconciliation, Lord God. That we're going out to the people, that we're ministering to their needs, Lord God. That they don't just see us, Heavenly Father, but they see you in us, Lord God. Oh, thank you, Heavenly Father. We're perceiving faith, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you that needs are being met, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for the death, burial, and resurrection, Lord God. That we identify in you, Lord God. That we identify in you, Lord God. I thank you, Heavenly Father, that we're coming into the full knowledge of righteousness. That we're coming into the full knowledge of righteousness. Who we are in you, Lord God. That we are identifying in you, Lord God. The body. The body not separated from the head, but the body being the workmanship of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. She take little my no cake, take little my no shake take. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you that we're able to speak in tongues, Lord God. Thank you for our own personal prayer language with you, Lord God, that we speak mysteries, Lord God. That we speak mysteries, Lord God. Oh, thank you that you're moving in our midst, Lord God. Thank you that you're moving in our midst, Lord God. Key to little mano, shake to little mano, kate. Key to little mano, nate to little mano, shake to little mano, kate. Oh, thank you, Lord God, for the Holy Spirit that are leading people into the sanctuary, Lord God. That they're getting word, Lord God. That they're getting word, Lord God. That they're being taught, Lord God. That there's things that's being caught, Lord God. We thank you for our pastor, Lord God. Continue to increase them, Lord God. Continue to give them vision. Continue to give them dreams, Lord God. For your word says, when there's lack of vision, Lord God, that the people perish. So we thank you, Heavenly Father, for visionaries in our community, Lord God. We thank you for visionaries in our government, Lord God. We thank you for visionaries becoming president, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord God. Yes, thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. We thank you that the people are humbling themselves, Lord God. That they're humbling themselves, Heavenly Father. That they're humbling themselves, Lord God. That they're in repentance, Lord God. That they're turning away from wicked ways, Heavenly Father. And beginning to operate according to your word, Lord God. According to your spirit, Lord God. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord God, for your healing this land. Thank you, Lord God, for your healing our community. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, we just come together, Heavenly Father, in gratification, Heavenly Father, in thanksgiving, Lord God. We give you alone all the special, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you that we're beginning to see the length and the depth of your word, of your promises, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. We're beginning to see the depth of your wisdom, your knowledge, Heavenly Father, operating in our lives, Lord God. Heavenly Father. And in this bad Heavenly Father, now that we put our mouth on the situations and circumstances are change in our life. A new thing in our life. A new thing. God is doing a new thing in our life, Lord God. God is doing a new thing in our life, Lord God. If you were on one level, it's time to go to the next level. Hallelujah. If you were on one Heavenly Father, that things are changing. Things are changing. Things are leadership and authority of what a believer. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you that our thinking is beginning to change, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. We thank you that we're breaking off the system, Lord God. That we're beginning to operate according to the kingdom, Lord God. That we're not even just thinking about getting jobs, but we're thinking about creating jobs. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. That we're making disciples of men, Lord God. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your joy. For the scripture said that the joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of God's promises is your strength. You are in those promises. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you that we're sitting in the word. We're sitting in Christ, Lord God, in heavenly places. I thank you that the word is talking about us. Hallelujah. That's where our joy is. Not in our situation and circumstance, but joy is in the word. Unconditional love. Continue to show us the death and the live, the unconditional love. Hallelujah. Or it's long suffering, Lord God. That is patient, Lord God. That it endures forever, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. 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 I thank you that your saints are beginning to connect with you, Lord God. That your saints are beginning to connect with you as daddy. As daddy. As daddy. That personal relationship is beginning to grow, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. That the saints are maturing. 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 Just lift your hands and thank God that I'm maturing. I'm maturing in your things. I'm maturing in your things. Oh, hallelujah. I'm maturing in the word. I'm maturing in the word. Yes, I'm growing up. I'm growing up. And as I'm growing, as I'm growing up, I'm getting up. As I'm growing up, I'm getting up. And then as I'm getting up, I'm getting out. And as I'm getting up, I'm getting out. And as I'm getting up, I'm getting out. And as I'm getting out, I'm bringing somebody else in. And as I'm getting out, I'm bringing somebody else in. For the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah that our co-workers aren't going to hell. Hallelujah that our co-workers aren't. Shines, Heavenly Father. I thank you, Heavenly Father, that we're bringing people into the kingdom of the light, Lord God. The kingdom of God. The kingdom of prosperity. The kingdom of good health. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you that your word said that you wish above all things that we prosper and be in good health. So I thank you that our minds are what? Maturing. I thank you that our soul is prospering. For the scripture says, even as your prosper. I thank you, Heavenly Father, that we continue to emotionally connect to your will, that our intellect is based upon your laws, that our imagination is based upon your promises, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. 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 I thank you because our relationship is growing in you. Our relationship is beginning to grow with our friends. Our relationship is beginning to grow with our family. Our relationships are beginning to grow with our acquaintances, Heavenly Father. And that they see you, Lord God. So our relationships is based upon our relationships with you, Lord God. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, that when we walk in line with that law, the scripture said all law, all law, all law, that's spiritual and that's natural, Heavenly Father, can be hung upon these two commandments. The commandments of loving God with all your heart, soul, and mind, and loving your neighbor can flow in here. We thank you, Heavenly Father, when prosperity is needed, we can flow in prosperity. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Thank you that we're going to another level in you. We thank you that we're going to another level in you. A level that we have not yet seen before. But I thank you, Heavenly Father, for faith. I thank you for faith. I thank you for faith. Faith operates when? Now. Now. Open your mouth and give him glory. Hallelujah. 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 That faith is now. Hallelujah. That faith is now. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. It's the substance of the word. It's the substance of the promises. Thank you that now faith is the substance of things hoped for. The evidence of things not yet seen. Lord God, it's time for the saints to get. Hallelujah. It's got to be begin to flow out of. It's got to begin to flow out of. Don't just speak the word from your head. Speak it from your innermost being. Speak it from down under. Oh, hallelujah. When you speak it from your head, a lot of times the enemy don't do nothing. But when you speak it from the innermost part of it, he hears Jesus. And you know what happens when he hears Jesus? He gets to move. He gets to move. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you want different accounts, every account in the Bible, after Jesus was called to his ministry, every time he seen the enemy or one of his core hearts, they was on the move. They was on the move. Oh, hallelujah. So if the enemy is operating in your life and you begin to speak the word from the innermost part, I tell you, the enemy, he will remove himself. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Lord God. Speak the word over your finances. Increase over your finances. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Speak to your offering. Oh, glory to your name, Lord God. Speak to your offering. Speak to your offering. Thank the Lord for that which you have to give. Speak to it. Tell him, say, I'm giving this to God, but I want you to bring some of your friends back. Oh, hallelujah. 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 I remember on one parable, the rich young ruler. He told him to give all that he had. And then he told him to sell all you got, give to the poor. And the rich young ruler, he dropped his head and walked away. Ooh. And Jesus said, those who sacrifice the ways of this world. Those who sacrifice the ways of this world, he said, I'll add them to your account. Today. Today. Huh? He said, he'll pull those things which are from heaven, establish them on earth for you today. Hallelujah. In this dispensation. Oh, glory to your name, Lord God. If you got a need, a seed will meet that need. Oh, hallelujah. Speak the word. Speak the word. Believe only the word. Oh, glory to your name. Glory to your name, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, that you sent your word. That we shall not perish, but we shall have everlasting life. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you that you came that we may have life and have it what? More abundant. Oh, ain't no lacking more abundant. Hallelujah. 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 It's time to get moving, saints. It's time to get moving, saints. Oh, glory to your name, Lord God. Glory to your name, Lord God. She Taylor the one, okay, Taylor the one, no, Shay Taylor. Shay Taylor the one, okay, Taylor the one.
And be glad. over. I want to flow over. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me. Say, fill me up. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God.
Jesus, more of you. Again, I want
Yeah. your desire, God.
Your desire fulfilled in me. And I give myself away.
Hallelujah, I give myself away.
I give myself away. So you can use.
I give hallelujah.
All of me, I give you.
said it.
Every decision, your truth, God. Hallelujah, Jesus.
on, saints. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. 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 For saying not your will, but God's will be done. Jesus withheld nothing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And all to him I owe. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. How many glad Jesus didn't change his mind? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Praise the name of God. Hallelujah. He's worthy. He's worthy. His Spirit is here. Hallelujah. Receive it. Oh, thank you, God. Receive it. Receive it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. We just want to share just with you briefly. Amen. Hallelujah. The purpose of spiritual warfare, you know. I was so thankful for the prayer that we will become as one. That we will be unified as the body of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And not think that our war is against each other.
Amen.
How many were blessed? How many seen the movie War Room? And I know some people are studying. Amen. The material with War Room. So then we have people, even in the body of Christ, who wants to come against the word war, come against spiritual warfare. But I was saying, I said, can't we just all get along? You know, I wish we wouldn't do things like that. You know, just... How many of your mother or somebody told you growing up, if you can't say anything good, don't say it. They didn't say anything. They said, if you can't say nothing good, just don't say nothing at all. You know, and so, you know, I wish that the body of Christ would get to that point where, you know, we learn to promote each other and be prayerful and not come against each other. And, you know, I'm thinking those who are against war or spiritual warfare, I don't know what world they live in, but I want to just explain to you the purpose of spiritual warfare today, and I won't be before you long. I want us to end our session today in intercessory prayer for the persecuted church, and along with that, I have a lesson. But a lot of times we think when people reject us at church and they talk about us and they ostracize us and they keep us out of their little groups, we're being persecuted, and that is true in that sense. That is a form of persecution, but I want to take us to another level today of what it really means to be persecuted. Amen. Prayer warriors to come up, amen, and really intercede for those who are being persecuted. But before we do that, let's talk about what is spiritual warfare or the purpose of it. One thing we have to realize that we live in a three-dimensional world. Amen. It's three-dimensional. And spiritual warfare is three-dimensional. And perhaps that when we find out what is really going on, I have a relative to say, what's really going on? When we find out what's really going on, amen, we will realize, hallelujah, how important spiritual warfare is. The first thing we need to realize is that the social battle. It's a social battle between the believer and the world. That's the first part of spiritual warfare, is that we're in a social battle. Yes. So what you mean by social battle? Well, let's see what Jesus said in St. John chapter 15, verses 18 through 27. You know, Jesus said it all. When we really look at scripture, there's answers. St. John chapter 15. And where's my evangelistic, what does that Mother King say? My, we can read like a evangelistically.
Loudly, clearly, and evangelistically.
Okay, so you must be my reader, Mr. Chair. You already know what's going on. St. John chapter 15. Verse 18.
If the world hates you, know that it hated me before it hated you.
Right there, that's the first battle. I don't know why we want people to love on us. Sometimes they don't like it just because. They may not even know why. Amen. You walk in with all this light and the glory of the Lord upon you, and you think they're going to embrace you? Jesus said they hated him before they hated you. That's the first part of spiritual warfare, is the social battle. Amen. It's the social battle. Keep reading, sister.
If you belong to the world, the world would treat you with affliction and would love you as its own.
Oh, they're going to love their own. Come on.
But because you are not of the world, no longer one with it, but I have chosen you.
You're chosen. Come on. You've been chosen out of the world. Hello. Come on.
The world hates you.
Wake up, saints.
Remember that I told you, a servant is not greater than his master.
Come on.
If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they keep my word and obey my teachings, they will also keep and obey yours.
Come on.
But they will do all this to you because of my name and on my account. For they do not know or understand the one who sent me.
Come on.
If I had not come and spoken to them, they would not be guilty of sin. But now they have no excuse for their sin. Whoever hates me also hates my Father.
Come on.
If I had not done among them the works which no one else ever did, they would not be guilty of sin. But now they have both seen and have hated both me and my Father. But that this word written in the law might be fulfilled.
Might be fulfilled.
They hated me without a cause.
My.
But when the Comforter, Counselor, Helper, Advocate, Intercessor, Strength, and Standby comes.
Come on.
Whom will I send to you from the Father? The Spirit of Truth, who comes from the Father, will testify regarding me. But you will also testify and be my witness, because you have been with me from the beginning.
Hallelujah. The first part of spiritual warfare is the social battle. And that hate doesn't have to come from your job. It doesn't have to come in road rage. It could be right in your home. Amen. Because people don't understand your purpose. Hallelujah. They don't understand why you make the decisions you make. I like what my pastor taught us years ago. God doesn't even do math like we do math. Amen. He might divide before he multiplies. Hello. So when you do things God's way, people won't understand you, and they won't like you. Amen. And don't use your energy trying to make them. You just keep living like Jesus tell you to live. Amen. So Jesus said, you're not above me, he's the Lord. Amen. You can't be above Jesus. And Jesus said they hated him world gonna love you. That's the first warfare.
Yes, yes.
Amen. And if it's in your family, that means you need to be doing spiritual warfare. Because you don't want your family lost. You don't want your neighborhood lost. Brother prayed this morning. We don't even want our co-workers lost. Amen. So they don't even know why they feel the way they feel. But you know.
Yes.
But the Comforter has come. Woo, glory to God. Describe him one more time for me. The Comforter has come. He's the what?
He is the counselor.
Yes, the counselor. Hold on, counselor. Sister. Don't go too fast. Whoa. He's the what? The counselor.
Yes.
He's there to comfort you, to counsel you if you need it. And when he put it in you, you can give it out. Come on. So he's the counselor. The counselor is in you. When I teach counsel, when I take counseling, I let people know the first, your first counselee is you. Counsel you from the counselor that lives in you. He's the counselor. Come on, sis. He's the what?
Helper.
The helper. He's a present help in your time of need. Ooh, I love him right now. Cut my G. Go ahead, sister.
Advocate.
The advocate. Mm. The one who will stand in between you and in those ungodly people. He's your He'll stand up for you.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He'll plead your case.
Yeah.
Oh, bless his name. I don't know why you're still sitting there.
Yeah.
Thinking about the counsel of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, yes. Yes.
Oh, bless him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. Read, sister.
Intercessor.
The intercessor. Standing in the gap, making up the hedge. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. I'm glad for the attorney I have. Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit. I was looking at the news. I thought, now I know they know those folks are guilty. How they court-appointed attorneys. And they know. I had one attorney say, pray for me because I already know they thugs and they guilty. You know, but you got to stand there and plead their case, right? But how many so glad for the truth? The truth you know will set you free. Hallelujah. That truth stands in the gap for you and me. Oh, how he loves you and me. Oh, thank you, God. Hallelujah. I'm ready to shout right now. So that's the first battle. It's the social battle between the believer and the world. The world's going to hate you. In fact, they're supposed to. They shouldn't even feel comfortable.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you,
God.
Amen.
And then the second battle is between the flesh and the spirit. Galatians chapter 5. Amen. Your flesh will not ever. And I may not be using good grammar, but you got the point. The flesh will never want to please God. Amen. Your flesh don't want to pray. Your flesh don't want to live right. Your flesh don't want to read the word. Your flesh don't want to even shout dance. And some of us let it have its way in that part, but anyway. It never wants to do what God wants. That's the second part of spiritual warfare. Okay, who's my reader? Galatians 5:16.
But I say, walk and live.
Uh-huh.
In the Holy Spirit.
Woo!
And controlled and guided by the Spirit.
Uh-huh.
Then you will certainly not gratify the cravings.
Uh-oh.
And the desires of the flesh.
You mean it's possible?
Yes.
Not to gratify the flesh?
Yes.
You mean it's possible not to serve the flesh?
Yes. Yes.
Here, I'm going to give you the mic and read that one.
All right. Tell them what version you read it from.
Oh, this is...
Oh, the Bible, so they know you read the Bible.
It's the Amplified Bible, and it's Galatians 5:16, and it says, "But I say, walk and live habitually in the Holy Spirit, responsive and controlled and guided by the Spirit. Then you will certainly not gratify the cravings and desires of the flesh." That's of human nature without God.
Come on up here, sister. That human nature. That human nature can be checked. You said on purpose. It can be checked and be told what to do.
Yeah.
We're going to obey God's word. Amen. After a while, that flesh will die. No, she ain't giving in. She's not giving in on that one. He's not giving in on this one.
Amen.
Leave it alone. We already know the spirits are controlling that area. Okay, go ahead. Thank you, sister. We says.
For the desires, of the flesh are opposed to the Holy Spirit, and the desires of the Spirit are opposed to the flesh. Godless nature, for these are antagonistic to each other.
Wow.
Continually withstanding and in conflict with each other. So that you are not free, but are prevented from doing what you desire to do.
Uh-oh. I need to stand up so you read from the Bible. The holy be out of here. Come on.
But if you are guided, led by the Holy Spirit, you are not subjected to the law. Now the doings, practices, flesh are clear and obvious. They are immorality, impurity, indecency, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, anger, ill temper, selfishness, divisions, dissensions, party spirit, fractions, sex with particular opinions, heresies, envy, drunkenness, carousing, and the like. I warn you beforehand, just as I did previously, that those who do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruits of the Spirit, the work which is presence within, accomplish his love, joy,
peace,
patience, gentleness, meekness, humility, self-control, which means self-restraint, continence. Against such things, there is no law that can bring a change. And those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh, the godly human nature with its passions and appetites and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. If by the Holy Spirit we have our life in God, let us go forward, walking in line, our conduct controlled by the Spirit. Let us not become vainglorious and self-conceited, competitive, and challenging and provoking and irritating to one another. Envying and being jealous of one another.
Amen.
That will preach. Amen. No competition. We can get that out of church. We get competition and jealousy, we might get somewhere. Amen. But the scripture says, such were some of you. Amen. So when you're a new creature in Christ Jesus, the fruit of the Spirit should be controlling you. Amen. I like that part. Don't even irritate each other. Oh, wow. We have to go back in prayer. You know, you're supposed to irritate. And please don't irritate your pastor. That's the first place. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. I'm going to let those scriptures speak for themselves. So the second battle is the flesh in the spirit. Let your flesh know who's in control. The spirit. Amen. That old me is dead. God help us. If we get sexual immorality out of church, we'll go somewhere. Amen.
Amen.
Don't start preaching it if you want to keep your congregation.
Amen.
It's the truth. Amen. Because people say, I'm going to live holy, but the opportunity comes. Oh, yeah. I've heard. Well, anyway, so move right along. The second battle, the three-dimensional spiritual warfare, is the believer in the world, the flesh and the spirit, and the third one is against believers and evil spiritual powers. And we know that from Ephesians 6 and 10. Let's go ahead and read it. All of these are familiar scriptures. But I want us to know, amen, why we have spiritual warfare.
Ephesians 6 and 10. In conclusion, be strong in the Lord.
Yes.
Be empowered through your union with Him.
Yes.
Draw your strength from Him, that strength which is boundless might provide. Put on the whole armor of God, the armor of heavy armed soldiers, which God supplies, that you may be able to successfully stand up against the strategies and the deceits of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of this present darkness, against spiritual forces, wickedness in the heavens, supernatural fear. Therefore, put on God's complete armor, that you may be able to resist and stand your ground on the evil day of danger. And having done all to stand, to stand firmly in your place, stand therefore, holding ground, having tightened the belt of truth around your loins, having put on the breastplate of integrity and moral rectitude and right standing with God, and having shod your feet in the preparation to face the enemy, to produce the good news of the gospel of peace, to lift up all of the covering, the shield of faith upon which you can quench all the flaming missiles of the wicked one, and take the helmet of salvation, the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying at all times, on every occasion, in every season, in the Spirit, with all prayer and supplication, to keep an end, alert watch, and strong purpose, to persevere and interceding in the behalf of the saints, and praying also for me, that I may give utterance, which I might open my mouth to proclaim boldly the mysteries of the good news, the gospel.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say hallelujah for God's word.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
God's word.
So unless you are a believer and you don't need to stand, then I guess you don't need spiritual warfare. But this scripture, I'm a believer and I see me all up in this scripture. Amen.
Amen.
How many see yourself in this word?
Amen.
I have to put on the whole armor of God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And I'm so glad it's not my armor, it's God's armor.
Amen.
Amen. So that means it'll fit. That means it works. Amen. That means it'll do what it said it will do. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. So we are standing. And then it describes all types of spiritual wickedness, principalities, and powers that we already have been given authority over.
Amen.
Amen. So I'm going to go on with this thought. So then if we have all this, then why do we have to have spiritual warfare? Because we have an enemy that will not give up. Sometimes we give up before the enemy gives up. He's not going to give up. Jesus has paid it all. Amen. For our healing, for our prosperity, everything we need, God has already provided. But we have an enemy in this world. It is his territory. He is the small G-O-D of this world. So he continues to attack. He's blinded the minds of unbelievers. And he continuously attacks the believer. Amen. That's why we need spiritual warfare. And I've learned that even with spiritual warfare, and even with deliverance, people don't like the word deliverance today. But deliverance doesn't mean your head is spinning and you're spitting out green soup.
That's right.
Deliverance means I'm speaking the word. I'm decreeing the word. I'm declaring the word. And a change will take place. Amen. Spiritual warfare means I'm going in and I won't let go. Until God's word is manifested in my life or in the, or on the behalf of those I'm praying for. That's spiritual warfare. Amen. A made up mind. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Devil, shoot your best shot, but I won't give up.
Hallelujah.
I'm not backing up to you either.
Hallelujah.
Come on, Saint, get some backbone.
Hallelujah. Yep.
Hallelujah. Bring your report, but I got some backbone. I have some word that will never fail.
Yeah.
I have a pastor used to tell us weak, need, and jellyfish. Get rid of that spirit.
Oh my God.
Stand.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes.
I had a sister tell me, I don't like to come to prayer because every time I start praying and seeking the Lord, I get under heavy attack. And your point is? So I just don't come. True story. You know, really, that's giving too much to the devil.
Yeah.
You attack me, I'm going to pray more.
Yeah.
You attack me, I'm going to worship harder.
Yeah.
You attack me, I'm going to still get in the word.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I'm not backing up to you. Come on, saints.
Yeah.
Come on, Zion. It's time to go to a higher place in God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I'm not going to get on my hand clap worship today. I said, I better leave these people alone. They just going to clap for God. That's all they going to do.
Hallelujah.
But we need to engage in battle.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. Don't be moved by circumstance. When I preach to you, I'm preaching to me twice as much.
Yeah.
Don't give in to situations, circumstances. Amen. I'm holding on to God's word.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And I'm not backing up to no demon. Make that your testimony.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Devil, you can't scare me. Hello? You better say it in me. I'm not backing up. Hallelujah. Because I read somewhere Jesus said just a finger of God. He didn't say the whole head. Just one finger of God is enough for one demon. All I need is God's finger to point at you and tell you, back up, my child. Hallelujah. When you realize the devil is on a dog leash and who his master is, you'll stop running from it. But he's still his master. So he come barking like that roaring lion. You better put that word, that's that leash that'll pull them back. Amen. God is the word. And the word is God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, saints. I liked that prayer earlier. It's time to mature. It's time for a meet.
Hallelujah.
Every person alive is engaged in this battle.
Yes.
You born again, you engaged in this warfare, whether you want to acknowledge it or not.
Yes.
Amen. There's no neutral. You're in it. The war is on. You enlisted. You signed up. The day you made Jesus the Lord of your life, you signed up in this army. And the battle. I'm a humble person. I don't even talk about anybody. I don't know why the devil bothers me. Like, really? You need to wake up, smell the coffee, drink the coffee, smell the rose, and whatever it is it'll take to wake you up. Because the day you enlisted, you are a target. Amen. But you're not going to take me down, devil. Hallelujah. Don't be afraid to say that. We can only say that because Jesus said it. Amen. He's given us that authority. He's given us, amen, that power. Amen. Hallelujah. And then we're going to go to our main verse, 2 Timothy 3:1. And I'm not telling you to go after the devil and tell him I'm not scared of you. I'm just saying when he brings things, you better know who you are in Christ. Amen. 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 I'm not afraid because God has not given me a spirit of fear. Amen. You can come under attack. But you have to learn how to stand. A spirit of fear came upon me. It was really bad. One time in my life, the spirit of fear came, and I opened the door, apparently. Because every time my phone would ring, I would jump. I was afraid to even go to the mailbox and check the mail. I had a spirit of fear I allowed somewhere to come upon me. But I tell you what, when my eyes got open, when the eyes of my understanding was enlightened, I gave that spirit of fear its eviction notice. Didn't have 30 days. You didn't have one more second. You are out of here now in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. 2 Timothy, what did I say? 3:1.
But understand this, that in the last days will come perilous times of great stress and trouble. Hard to deal with and hard to bear. For people will be lovers of self and utterly self-centered, lovers of money and aroused by inordinate, greedy desires for wealth, proud and arrogant and contemptuous, boasters. They will be abusive, blasphemous, scoffing, disobedient to parents, ungrateful, unholy, and profane.
Just start right with that disobedience to parents. People are lovers of themselves. Whoever thought you would see the day when our restrooms would be, I don't know how to describe it other than gender friendly. You know, they want to make restrooms where if you're transgender, you can go in whatever restroom that fits you. I don't know how to describe all that. Y'all know what I'm talking about. They won't even bring it into schools. Have mercy, Lord. Public places. People are lovers of themselves, lovers of pleasure, more than lovers of God. Hallelujah. Help us today, God. But I believe it was Job or Jeremiah that says, I found the one whom I long for. And his banner over me is love, Jehovah Nisi. Hallelujah. I found my love. His name is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And he's sufficient. How many can say that? Doesn't have anything to do whether you're married or single. Jesus should be sufficient to you anyway. Amen.
Amen.
He should be the only one that can fill voids in your life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So we're living in perilous days. We're living in the last days. Amen. I don't preach politics, but even in our political world. I mean, really? Our candidates, really? And you don't think we're in a war? You better pray and pray real strong. Amen. That God's will be done. Hallelujah. That his kingdom reigns. Hallelujah. In this life, you better pray. It's not a joke. So I don't care. Jesus, Lord of my life, I don't care who get to be president. Look, if you on this earth, some of those laws will affect you whether you want it to or not. You better pray. Amen. It's praying time. It's perilous days. We're in the last days. We don't have time. Amen. Ain't nobody got time for that?
Nope.
Playing around? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's serious. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So spiritual warfare is three-dimensional. One is believer in the world. Two, flesh in the spirit. Three, believers and evil spiritual powers. God is no respecter of person, neither is the devil. Amen. You don't care what your title is, what your position is. And you already know, I'm going to tell you again, the areas he attacks, believers, the unbelievers, he's already blinded them. If you think he's in the club, you better wake up again. Because the people that's in the club and all those places, their minds are already blinded.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
But he's coming to the believers. He wants to attack the believers. And one way he attacks is in your worship. In your worship. What's in your belly? Amen. We better learn bodies.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. I enjoyed the worship today. We didn't have music as far as instruments, but the worship came forth.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Worship. Stop looking around. I don't know if anybody was or not, but I'm just telling you. You know, we look around. Oh, look at Sister So-and-so. Oh, yeah, she always dancing over there. What's in your belly?
Yeah.
Come on with a pure worship.
Yeah.
Amen. God is worth more than a hand clap. Give him a pure worship.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Cheerleading days are over. Hallelujah. We should have to tell people, lift your hands, kick up one leg, jump up three times and turn around. Worship comes from your belly. Amen. It's not calisthenic. Were you exercising? Amen. Because if you're not worshiping, the enemy has your mind somewhere else.
Yes.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. God is worthy of a worship. I read somewhere, from the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, he's worthy to be praised. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Then he attacks you with the word, against reading the word. Amen. I believe God is pleased with this setting because all of us are busy. And we have plenty of things we can be doing even today. But when we set aside this time, amen, to just seek the Lord for these 4 hours, I believe God is pleased. Amen. Hallelujah. Because we're giving him time.
Yes.
We're willing to wait in his presence.
Hallelujah.
We want to hear a word from the Lord.
Amen.
Praise God. God is pleased.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. And he's much easier to please than people. Because you'll never please people.
Yeah.
Amen. But your extension to God is pleasing to him. And I love God because when we reach out to him, he's right there. Ooh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So we'll get back to the word. I had a friend tell me, I just remember I read my word in 3 days. Oh, really? Did you eat the last 3 days? Then skip a meal. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, and snacks. You remember to feed that flesh. You see the war there? But Jesus said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that what? Proceeded from the mouth of God.
That's good.
This word has to be a life or death situation. I can't live without it. And I sure don't want to die without it. Hallelujah. It's my bread. It's my meat. It's my dessert. It's my everything. God responds to people who love his word. Amen. So the first thing, one of the things the enemy wants to attack is you too tired to read. The next thing is your daily walk. Amen. There's no such thing as a cussing saint. And saints who do all kind of things and say they born again. No, sir. No, ma'am. There is a difference. There are standards. There is no God understands. God understands his word. Well, I slip and dip a little bit. God understands. No, he doesn't. He understands his word we just read that says put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand. Come on here. Come on out. These smoking Christians. Come on out the smoke hole. Got a smoke hole at the church. A certain spot where the saints go out and smoke. You better come out of there.
Yes, yes.
You better come out. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. She named those things of the flesh. The scripture did. Partying, fornicating. One of the biggest sins in the church. You better come out of that. I'm like my mentor, Cindy Trim. Get rid of that. Just get rid of it. The power's in you to do that.
Amen.
Grace. Amen.
Grace.
I know our organization got mad at a bishop. It's a female bishop. Said, all you preachers with a girlfriend, you out. She about lost half her preachers, but they was gone. You out of here. We live by the word.
Yeah.
Amen. Come on, saints, it's prayerless time. Should be a difference. People should know the difference.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Your daily walk is important.
Hallelujah.
And your work for God. Amen. What has God called you to do? People need to know there's a calling. Well, I'm not called to pastor. Good. Not called to be an apostle. That's good too. But you are called to give the word.
Amen.
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 This word ought to be so good we can't hold it in.
Amen.
You tell them about that good buffet. Girl, I went there, let me tell you. You tell them all about the meat and the vegetables and the dessert. Girl, I'm so full, I still got my dessert. I got to go though, but I got it. We can talk it. We're not ashamed. Amen. Speak the word. Amen. Share the word. You have been called to do that. Amen. Hallelujah. No, everyone's not called a pastor. The Bible tells me. Everybody called a pastor? No. Everybody called him? No. That's already answered. But is everybody called to share the gospel? The first two words of gospel is G-O. Amen. When Jesus said go, I strongly suggest that you go and preach the gospel to all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. That was not a suggestion. That's a command. Amen. Amen. How many love Jesus?
Amen.
Spiritual warfare is important. How many dimensions are there in spiritual warfare?
Three.
And I want us to see how important it is to pray for people that are being persecuted. I get emails on a daily basis about churches, about people who are losing their lives because they stand for the gospel. We get upset because somebody look at us funny. But these are people who are really suffering. Amen. Because of their love and their stand. You go here, bro. The love and their stand. For Jesus. Come on, saints. Proceed. Many of us can't take someone talking about us. Let alone get on your knees and a gun to your head. Come on, let's go and pray in the Spirit. This is our watch of intercession. This is the prayer watch for intercession. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to
Father God, we just come to you, Jesus. So many are being persecuted, Father, but even where the persecuted are, you're still there. Oh God, we just lift you up. We lift you up, Lord Jesus. We just praise you, Lord Jesus, for what you're doing in other countries, Lord. Oh God, as well as here that you're bringing the word of God, Lord Jesus, by messengers who are not afraid of the evil one. Father, we stand with them in their persecution, Lord Jesus. We stand with them anointed, ready for the mission, ready for the purpose, and ready for the battle, Lord, that your word must go forth over all the face of the earth. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, as you are our strength, Lord. You are their strength as well. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you have given them wisdom and the discernment that they must serve you and serve you alone, that they will not bow down to the idol. They will not bow down to the evil one. They will not bow down to what man think is right, but only your word is true, Lord. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you're a mighty God, Lord, and that we will live for you as well, Lord, that we will take our Bibles and treasure each and every word, Lord. Oh, God, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that there is a mission, that there is a purpose. Oh, God, we know, Lord Jesus, that you are preparing even their young people, Lord, for the battle, for the fight, and those, Lord Jesus, that are doing the persecution, Lord. Oh, God, let them be saved as well. Let them open their ears, Lord, to hear your word, to hear your word, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, you said not one shall be lost, but all shall be saved in the name of Jesus. We praise you for it right now. We thank you, Lord, for what you're doing, what you've already set forth in the future, Lord, that we and they as well have the victory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus for and we thank you that your word declare, Father God, that Lord, persecution may come, Father God. But Lord, we thank you that you deliver them all through all, Father God. We thank you, as Paul says, that he was persecuted in Antioch, but Father God, that he endured it and he was delivered, Father God. We declare deliverance in this nation, Father God. Deliverance in every country, every nation, every people, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for sending, we send your word, Father God, right now in the name of Jesus. For those who are enduring, Father God, hardship, Father God, we declare, Father God, in prayer and intercession, Father God, relief come in the name of Jesus. That they will be strong, Father God. That they will be strong and stand stronger, Father God, in this and their hour, Father God. We pray in Jesus' name, Father God, that where weakness is, Father God, your strength, Father God, comes. We pray in the name of Jesus, Father God, that the enemy, Father God, those who have come against them, Father God, who we know, Father God, is not the flesh, but is the enemy. But we pray that their lives will be turned around, that salvation will come, Father God. We thank you that their hearts, Father God, will turn to you. We thank you for visions and dreams, Father God. We thank you that people are seeing you where the ministry and also that the missionaries are going in, where they cannot go, that your vision, your angels, you're declaring that they're rising up in those areas, Father God, and they are bringing and letting people see that Jesus is real, Father God, and that their hearts are changed and coming to them. We thank you for a transformation, Father God, in the minds of those, Father God, in our nation, Father God, that we want to take the word to heart and see, Father God, that, Lord, your word is true, and that we have a call and desire, Father God, to go forth and go, Father God, and be disciples, and not only in our land, but in all the nations of the world. And, Father, we can do this not only as we go and travel, but we can do this, Father God, in prayer. We thank you that this avenue is great that you created, Father God, and we can stand, Father God, and make a difference. We can be a liberator, Father God, from your kingdom as you have called and liberated us in this hour. We thank you that Jesus came to bring freedom, Father God. We're not enslaved to anything. And so we speak, Father God, that our Christians, our brothers and sisters, Father God, are no longer enslaved, Father God, to the things that enslave them. We pray, first of all, they're not enslaved in their mind. Because physically there's things going on, but we pray for a transformation
that there will be no enslavement to fear, no enslavement to men, no enslavement to bondage. We pray that they are free. We call them free in their minds, Father God. And we just pray, Father God, your blood, a protection of your to surround them, Father God, a hedge of protection. We call it forth, Father God, in Jesus' name. We pray, Father God, that you deliver them, Father God. Your hand, Father God, your, by the power of your hand, you deliver them, Father God. And we just give your name the praise and the glory. We thank you, Father God, as missionaries go in. We are the light of the world, and they go in. Light brings us to just dispel darkness. And so we say that darkness is dispelled as the missionaries are going through this various places, and these feel that there is the darkness being dispelled, the leadership and the higher position of authority is being dispelled in Jesus' name. We thank you that principalities are being pulled down in Jesus' name as we pray. We thank you that every territorial spirit, every dominion, and everything that's taken place, they're pulled down, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you that the Christians, all Christians around the world, and our nations are taking our position and authority, Father God. We're praying from a place of authority, Father God. When we walk in, Father God, there is a great commission to speak things. But we thank you, Father God, that we're brought up in the Lord, so when we walk in these territories, we can just walk in and that we're light, and that darkness will have to flee in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father God, you called us. You called us in this hour, Father God, to rise up and take our place in authority. And we rise up in this hour. We come together in this hour in harmony. Everything that separates us in traditions and religion or whatever, we come and together as one in unity, and we come to defy the kingdom in Israel. We just come together, we just fight, and we stand against the enemy. We just stand united, Father God. And as we stand, Father God, your word declares that everything that must fall. And so we're just speaking that these things that are around us, the believers, our sisters and brothers in Christ, the things that have come against them, things that have come against them, as we come and unite ourselves together, these things are falling, whether they be another nation, persecution in our neighborhoods, persecution coming from our family members, persecution even coming in the United States, Father God. We stand against these things that are subtle, Father God. We see it in nations, Father God, but they're subtle here. We thank you, Father God, that we're standing against this, and we come against it in the name of Jesus. We don't come in our own might and strength, but Father God, we come in the power of your might and strength. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Father God. We thank you for delivering us, Father God. In Jesus' name.
God, we thank you today, God. God, we pray for persecution in the church today, God, amongst the members, God. God, we pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that we put our flesh under subjection, God, and deny it, God, that we will begin to love one another and talk nice to each other, edify each other, lift one another up in the name of Jesus, God. God, we bind the spirit of flesh that it don't glory in your sight, Lord. We speak love and peace and joy, your spirit, Lord, amongst your people, God, that we may go out, Lord, and bring your word and be a light to those that are lost and be saved, God. God, we bind the spirit of jealousy that works against us and competition, God, in the name of Jesus. We bind that spirit of control, God, in the name of Jesus, God. We put it under subjection, God. Make it submissive to you, Lord, in your word, Lord. Oh, Father, let us sweet, 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 sweet Savior be amongst us. Let us talk love and kindness to one another, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we need each other to survive. Oh, God, we just bind the devil right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. We ask that your glory come in, God. Oh, speak. Oh, God, speak to your people, God. Oh, God, don't let us persecute one another when we're out from amongst the church, God. Help us to be saved all day long, God. Hallelujah. When we're in and out of your presence, Lord, let us be a light to the world, God. Oh, because they're lost, Lord, in the name of Jesus, God. And they need to see love amongst their brother, God, in order that they may be saved, Father. In the name of Jesus, oh God, in
amongst those, God. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, we bind every witchcraft and warlock spirit, God. Oh, da, 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 oh, shot, da, 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 oh, shot. That comes to persecute us, God. We pour down every stronghold in the name of shot. In the name of Jesus, God, we put it down. That your spirit may rise and come forth. That you be lifted up in the name of Jesus. Time out. Oh, da, 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 oh, shot, da, 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 oh, shy. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, for letting the devil have his way. We bind him up right now. Jesus, we send your word forth, God. Oh God, that we can go and minister your word, God. Oh, no, 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 shout that without any hindrance, God, in the streets, God, and in our homes, Lord. Let us be an example, God, and we bind persecution on every hand. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Let your word come of this earth.
Oh God.
Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. We just appreciate this Spirit of the Lord and the way that God led us and flow through us this morning. I think that everybody, this heart should be gripped with a real hunger and a determination to really begin to pull out of our hearts even in a greater measure. And I think that the fasting, discipline, and you know, things that need to be accomplished worldwide, it's just going to take a lot of fasting and prayer, and even for our whole nation, considering the political upheaval and the things that, you know, our nation is in chaos. So we really need to really begin to fast and pray. Even as I was traveling yesterday over the city, I just saw a whole lot of our less prayer at churches. Pray, fast, that's what I'm hearing everywhere. And I think that that's a strong message that we need to hear and to heed. Amen. Amen. This could be our last election. It could be our last president. And I think that we really need to take things very seriously. How many can say amen? And let's pray while we still have an opportunity. Let's pray for nations. I was really touched with that film and how those Christians are persecuted. And we have so much, and God has blessed us to the extent where, you know, we just take the things of God so casual. So let's begin to get more and more serious what we can do. We can begin to get serious, amen, about worship, prayer, the word, on a local level, personally. How many can say amen?
Amen.
How many believe we can do more?
Amen.
How many we can push the plate back more?
Yes.
How many are willing to say yes to God? How many willing to say yes? Amen. Praise God. So we're going to announce our consecration tomorrow. And some serious fasting and praying. I will be thinking about even during the day, during the week, come out. During the day, those that's not working, and just really begin to travail and cry out for our nation, for our community. There's a whole lot we can do just right around us. Amen. There's a whole lot we can do within the church among believers that's really relaxed and complacent. And prayer, amen. We can do a whole lot among ourselves. How many can say amen? There's a lot of people within the church that needs to be admonished. Amen. And so it's time for us to pray and stop praying and playing. Amen. Our salvation is nearer than what we have believed. Jesus is coming soon. How many believe that? How many know he's coming soon? He's coming soon. And we want to do all that we can to prepare our hearts for it. So the spirit of the prayer watch, prayer vigil. How many were blessed? How many were really blessed? Amen. So I'm sure that all of us have been ministered to. We just want to be lesson to this vision. This is a tremendous vision, and I believe that it has a lot of potential, and I believe that there's a whole lot we can do in order to make things that God has given Sister Deborah, amen, a lot easier for us to enjoy the full benefits of what God has placed on this good lesson. We just don't want to take things for granted. You know, maybe the next time we can have our musician in place, we can have our singers in place, and we can, you know, praise God, enrich the efforts that we have put forth and make them a lot more effective. And we will be making the hands of our leader. Amen. How many believe that this is order of God? Steps of a good man are what? Order of God. I believe this service has been ordered of God. This monthly vigil, prayer vigil, has been ordered of God. We just want to intensify our efforts by spending more time during the day. Amen. Some nights, I believe that we're going to endeavor to do at least 21 days before Easter. And we're going to try to get people out day and night. Amen. We're going to be announced. I just feel like crying and weeping just for those people who are in Syria right now. Amen. Amen. That's some serious stuff. People shut down at gunpoint. Amen. And we, amen. And we don't want to make the sacrifice of coming out and praying on a consistent basis. You know, this Western one is great, but we just got to get more committed. I think that we can sacrifice on a weekly basis, on a daily basis, and begin to speak the word and call those things that be not as though they are in our midst. Amen. Let's begin to think in terms of reaching out. Amen. We just don't want to come and pray, amen, and not reach out. Amen. How many believe that God can really stir us to reach out to people that have not heard, people that are complacent, people that need prayer, people that need deliverance, people that need, amen, a word from God. Amen. So we can start our movement, amen, just by reaching out and following through with our daily consecration. Father, we thank you. We give you praise and the glory. In Jesus' name, we thank you, God. Hallelujah. For the spirit of prayer, the spirit of consecration, the spirit of self-denial. My people, you said, call by my name, will humble themselves and pray, and seek your face and turn from their wicked way. Then will they hear from heaven, and I will heal their land. Forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. Lord, we need healing. We need deliverance. We need, hallelujah, to hear from you. Father, we give you praise and glory in Jesus' name.
All right. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you, be gracious to you. May the Lord bless everything that you put your hand to. Blessings going in, blessings coming out. We bind plots, tricks, and schemes of the enemy. We release the presence and the power of God. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, everyone, for coming.